Thanks for staying with us. Let's get you some entertainment updates now. The much-awaited release starring Vikram Devathirumagan is all set to hit the 70mm in a few days. The versatile hero once again stuns audience, donning the role of a mentally challenged adult. After a successful musical score in Adugulam, composer G.V. Prakash also makes a comeback with his all-time favorite director A.L. Vijay. The songs from the film are already a hit with the music box.
ஒரே ஒரே ராஜாவா
ஊர்ல வேற யாரும் இல்லையா?
இருக்காங்க.
ராஜாவோட மந்திரிங்க நாலு பேரு கூஜாவா.
கூஜாவா
ஒரே ஒரே ஊருக்குள்ள ஒரே ஒரே ராஜாவா.
தெய்வத்திருமகன், it's a superb journey for me. Three films I've completed with Vijay. This is the third film, தெய்வத்திருமகன். I had done Creedam, மதராஸ்பட்டினம். All the songs of Creedam and மதராஸ்பட்டினம் had taken me to the next level. A director is somebody, you know, it's a combination, doesn't like, it's not like, you know, only the song is a hit. Even the visuals, the director has to take to the next level, and Vijay has taken it to the next level, all my songs, and got me a great name. So the same with தெய்வத்திருமகன், the album has been superbly reached, and everywhere in the net, you know, people are raving about it. So I'm really happy about the combination and working with Vijay. And with Vikram, this is my first time. And with Mohan Natarajan, this is the first film I'm working with them. I'm really happy about the combination and the way the film has turned out. It'll be an emotionally good film, and I think people will like it.
Actually, we should be very proud to have people like Vikram in our industry. He's really good and his performance is superb. Especially when I'm doing the background score, I'm seeing how he's performing. And you know, according to his performance, I'm setting the RR in places. Some portions, you know, he's played it really well. I will go underplay with the RR. And somewhere, some portions, when he's gone subtle, I will go overboard. So the metering has been very interesting for me. And I'm very proud to work with artists like Vikram. Very good artist he is.
Moving on. Now, can a harmless tweet against failing public services lead to a terror trial like it is happening in the United Kingdom? Well, this is all about the Twitter joke trial against Paul Chambers. After comic Stephen Fry gathered considerable support from celebrities for tweeter Paul Chambers, he is being tried for jokingly tweeting that he would blow up the airport when it was indefinitely shut due to bad weather.
British actor and comic Stephen Fry has set out to educate British security agencies about the norms of tweeting, as he thinks they are a bunch of idiots. Fry has vowed to go to jail if that is what it takes to overturn the controversial Chambers verdict. Yes, the same Paul Chambers who had sent out a tweet in utter desperation last winter when airports were indefinitely shut due to heavy snowing. The tweet that cost him over £1,000 and a jail time read, "Robin Hood Airport is closed. You've got a week, otherwise I'm blowing the airport sky high." Furious at the verdict, Stephen Fry is backing Chambers to the hilt, saying the tweet was, "Chambers' tweet is an example of Britain's tradition of self-deprecating humor and banter, and you should not be locked up by a bunch of humorless idiots who see terrorists and weapons of mass destruction where there are none." Fry is not alone in thinking that it is important to protect freedom of speech, or at least the ability to recognize the difference between jokes and menacing terrorist threats. Recently, a charity event was organized to raise funds for Chambers' appeal. And celebrities such as Al Murray, Rufus Hound, Katie Brand, Father Ted and Graham Linehan supported the event.
There is no virtual escape then, is there? That's the news at this hour, but stay tuned to NDTV Hindu for a brand new episode of Enterprising Entrepreneurs with a very special couple debuting the art of trade with success.